Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Thursday, November 9th, made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Welcome to the last mild weather day of the week. Chief Meteorologist Dan Zero says we should see 60-degree temperatures today, but then some rain is going to move in, and as we approach the weekend, it will be much cooler. Temperatures in the 40s and 50s expected for Saturday and Sunday. Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. An 18-year-old college student from New Jersey remains in extremely critical condition this morning after being hit by a stray bullet walking in a local park in Nashville. Jillian Ludwig was from Wall, attending Belmont University. Classmates gathered for a music and prayer service on the campus last night. The alleged gunman is in custody. Police say Ludwig was not his intended target. He was firing into a car across the street when a bullet went astray and hit Ludwig in the head. She's described as a talented bass player who's a music business major at Belmont. It may sound like something out of The Sopranos, but federal prosecutors allege it was real-life Gambino crime family members that were terrorizing the owners of a Toms River restaurant. They believe they had been disrespected. Included in a federal indictment of 10 alleged mobsters is the story of Gambino captain Joe Brooklyn and an associate who got into an argument with a man inside Roxy's Bar and Grill. When they were asked to leave, Brooklyn got belligerent and threatened to burn the place down, according to court documents. In this photo, here he is seen purchasing a gas canister. It's alleged that he then called the restaurant, threatening the owners. The owners were attacked one night leaving Roxy's. Brooklyn and his associate are among 10 alleged Gambino members facing a wide-ranging indictment connected to a waste hauling and demolition business. An Ocean County teacher busted for lewd photographs inside a classroom is likely facing up to a year in prison. Toms River Middle School teacher Kyle Banner pleading guilty to 3 counts of child endangerment stemming from at-work sexually explicit selfies that he posted to social media. The 48-year-old Brick Township man's been suspended without pay since shortly after his arrest in April. His sentencing is not yet scheduled, but the state is seeking 364 days in the Ocean County lockup. Thousands of Palestinians continue to flee Gaza and Gaza City. On foot in an accelerating exodus, Israeli forces, meanwhile, are closing in on a hospital they claim hides the main command center for Hamas. Hamas, meanwhile, says they will release their remaining hostages if Israel agrees to a ceasefire. So far, Israel has rejected that offer. Officials are once again setting their sights on social media organizations and misinformation, chiefly surrounding the Hamas terror invasion of Israel last month. And a congressman from New Jersey is behind a plan to make TikTok and other platforms step up or pay up. Josh Gottheimer is on bipartisan legislation that requires social media companies to release reports about violations to their terms of service. Jonathan Greenblatt, CEO of the Anti-Defamation League, says since the Hamas invasion of Israel, they've seen a tsunami of anti-Semitism, hate, and misinformation. He believes this might help combat that. Investigators have now confirmed that that school bus that crashed in Edison did have a brake failure. There were kids on the bus headed to a local middle school when the driver was unable to stop the vehicle. The driver hailed by police for keeping a bad situation from becoming a tragic one. The driver was able to avoid hitting other vehicles, somehow slowing the bus before smashing a fence and hitting a house. There was only one minor injury. Are you thinking about doing home improvements in New Jersey? Before you do, check out my latest column that takes a look at the best home improvements that will raise your home's value in New Jersey. If you're thinking about a dream kitchen, a spa bathroom, or a luxury master suite, it may not be worth the money you're going to spend. The best home improvements to add value to your home in New Jersey, that's posted now at nj1015.com. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Thursday, November 9th, made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a great day.